Who's gonna win the race to Mars? Putting a human being on Mars would be one of humanity's crowning achievements, and it's something we've been thinking about for a while.
I'm old enough to remember the Apollo landings, and when the Apollo landings stopped in 1972, we were like, yeah, on to Mars by 1980.
And more recently, Elon Musk has said he'll have a Mars spacecraft ready for short trips by early 2019. We'll see about that. But even if it doesn't happen on that timeline, it's gonna happen. The real question is, who's gonna be first? Will it be Elon Musk and his obsession with not only going to Mars, but colonizing it? Or will it be the more conventional approach, somebody like NASA? It's like the tortoise and the hare, except in this case, the hare also has to worry about Tesla. Hey everyone, I'm Patrick Jones, and this is Cheddar Explores. To help me out, I have two experts ready to weigh in on whether we'll be getting to Mars anytime soon.
It's a long way away.
Visiting Mars is much more difficult than anything we've tried to do with astronauts.
We're barely beyond what in the game we call the PowerPoint engineering phase.
That's kind of deflating. It's not happening right away. So let's talk about what the challenges are. A womaned or manned trip to Mars would cost an insane amount of money. NASA projects that such a venture would run up a bill of about $100 billion over, let's say, 30 to 40 years. Money that SpaceX and NASA currently do not have. So Mars and the Earth have varying distances between them depending on where they are in their orbits. At their closest, the trip would take about a year.
Then, when you're there, you go, you land, you spend a couple days on the surface, you plant the flag, you salute, you dig up some Mars rock, and then what happens is you want to go home, but you got to wait for the next window.
At a minimum, a round trip to Mars would take 2 years, but it could be even as long as 3 to 4 years. And the longer you're there, the more supplies the crew needs.
That's a lot of sandwiches.
The weight of all this stuff needs to be calculated into how much fuel you need. And don't forget, fuel itself weighs a lot. So you'll need a pretty heavy rocket to get the job done. You also need to plan for the worst. What happens when something fails? And something will fail.
You have to design with repair in mind.
A good example of this is on the International Space Station. They began recycling human waste in order to preserve water, and that's great. But what scientists didn't realize until later on was that the system gets clogged with calcium and breaks down. Engineers had to do a redesign on the fly and find ways to fix that issue. And then remember how the distance comes into play.
Because if you have something break down on the space station, you've got to hang out maybe a month until the next supply ship gets to you. But if you're two-thirds of the way to Mars, you know, you're not getting any Amazon deliveries anytime soon.
The trip itself has its own issues. Once astronauts leave the protective nest of low Earth orbit, they could get sick from either radiation or solar flares. Finally, there's the issue of landing on Mars. Its thin atmosphere presents sort of a worst-case scenario. We've landed rovers there, but it wasn't easy.
Landing on the moon is surprisingly easy. You just use rockets. You come down through the vacuum of space right to the surface, you use rockets, you land. Landing on Earth isn't too hard either. We have a nice, bouncy, thick atmosphere. You belly flop on the atmosphere with a big heat shield, and that slows you down real good.
The Earth's atmosphere is thick enough to slow you down, but Mars is too thin to use that technique, and it's not a vacuum like the moon. So at least in the case of the landers, they needed to pull all the tricks out of their sleeves. This is me picking tricks out of my sleeves, apparently.
They come in with heat shield slowing, and then parachutes, and then rockets, and then in the case of Spirit and Opportunity, airbags. And they basically have like 4 or 5 different systems to get them to slow them down enough to land safely, because no one system's good enough.
And they'd need to get even more creative for a larger ship that would be carrying humans. Okay, so now that we've spelled out the issues, let's see where our contenders are. What's Elon's schedule looking like?
So as soon as you have schedule and Elon in the same sentence, you've got a problem.
Deadlines aren't exactly Elon Musk's thing, but results are. Right now, SpaceX is behind Musk's promise to send a ship to Mars in 2018. He doesn't have the size of the rocket he needs, but the one currently being built should be ready to run tests by 2020. They also don't have the infrastructure for deep space travel. They'd need to have something like NASA's deep space network.
It consists of three collections of dishes, one in California, one near Madrid, and one in Australia. And so as the Earth turns, at least one of those sites can see your distant spaceship. And so I sort of think of it as a rotating USB hub for the solar system. All the data from NASA's deep space probes flows into Earth through these three sockets.
If Musk doesn't have access to the deep space network and doesn't set up one of his own, there would be long gaps in communication with their vessel as the Earth turns. But on the brighter side, SpaceX doesn't require approval from Congress, nor does it have the normal red tape you see in government. NASA has been thinking about a trip to Mars for a long time. Also, NASA has access to a dependable stream of income thanks to our tax dollars and information from other space agencies around the world. I mean, it's NASA. Who is more likely to get a human being to Mars?
So I think there's a long way to go before anyone gets to Mars. The government-led efforts are more likely to be further along than any private effort.
But Congress isn't going to fund a human Mars program and give it a name and dollars and things like that until we're closer to being able to do it for some number of billion dollars that isn't too big a number that makes Congress sort of go white.
It could be a hybrid effort.
Well, Elon's going to get there when NASA hands him huge, huge bags of money.
Meaning NASA could essentially decide they want to use a SpaceX-built rocket to get them to the fourth planet from the sun. But wait, there's a twist. There could be an underdog story here.
The Chinese Academy of Space Technology is working on not Mars missions yet, but it's not so far off. They haven't yet gone to Mars, even robotically, but they will soon. So if we sit on our rears long enough, I think China will pass us. So that's something to keep watching.
A trip to Mars would open the door to a potential new home for human life. Or at the very least, could be a great new spot for an olive garden. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please like, comment, subscribe. We're making a lot of fun stuff here at Cheddar, and we hope you keep watching.